Hey Buzzers, welcome back to Inside Buzz, where we serve you the hottest tea in South African politics and entertainment. If you haven't already, make sure to hit the subscribe button and ring the bell so you never miss an update. Today we are diving into some spicy drama straight from Parliament. Julius Malema, the EFF leader known for his fiery speeches, just dropped a bombshell in Parliament. He boldly told President Ramaphosa, Parliament is not for soft-skinned people. Yep, you had that right. In his classic no-nonsense style, Malema clarified that he did not drag Ramaphosa's father into their heated debate, but get this, he even defended his stance, saying that mentioning facts, even if they involve someone's family, shouldn't be seen as an insult. Talk about stirring the pot. Malema was all about keeping it real, emphasizing that political work is all about robust engagement and speaking the truth, even if it gets a little uncomfortable. He called out the need for respectful and honest discourse despite the clashing opinions.
Yesterday, the president of the GNU spent a considerable time saying that our input and contribution during opening of Parliament debate was playing the man and not playing the ball. The president wrongly said that we previously insulted him by saying that his father was a police officer during the dark days of apartheid, and that even when such is a fact, he is proud that his father was a law enforcement officer of apartheid laws. Let's put the facts right in front of this parliament. We never ever have made any reference to president's father in this parliament, and even if we did, it would have been a statement of fact and not insult. To say someone's parent is a nurse, it will never be used as an insult. To say someone else's parent is a police officer can never be used as an insult. I spoke about your father in order for you to drag my grandmother unfairly so, because my grandmother has got nothing to do with what I'm doing here. So I want to state it very clear that, President, we respect each other and will continue to engage each other robustly. Secondly, Parliament and political work in general is not for soft-skinned people who will use all languages to complain whenever we give fair but robust and direct characterization of their political conduct. Here we speak truth and nothing else but the truth. In our characterization of the ball which you spoke about here, which you said we must play, we will also characterize the players to have a fuller picture of both subjective and objective political and ideological conditions. You can never only play the ball without understanding the strength and weaknesses of the player. We will also welcome, and this we did at a number of times, we welcomed and tolerated whosoever does that against us. When we get criticized by your side, even sometimes the political amateurs like Butima Namel, who come and attack us personally, we never respond to them. We never cry because we are not crybabies. We fight because we are fighters. Instead of crying, we fight. In politics, the individual's personal character is key to historical developments. Otherwise, why is there Nelson Mandela Day? The individual strength of Mandela is what we are drawn to reflect upon, learn from him as a leader, but more broadly as a human being. It is a fact that in light of the government of national unity, which originated from the white capitalist establishment, we needed to appreciate your own historical involvement with these white people, and a close attention to your personal political journey gives testament to the suspicion that this government was not actually created now. It came from long time ago because you were made a project long time ago. So we can save a lot of money by reducing cabinet, by removing deputy ministers. President, nalwena rea tlompana ibile rena plekete nalwena re fitari ya go each other's house. We don't need cabinet to make, we don't need parliament to make an appointment. When we want to see each other, we have done so before. And I criticize you even when it is just the two of us. I'm not criticizing you here because I see this honorable members of parliament. We will continue to engage each other robustly. You asked me a question and said, where were you? It was biologically impossible for me to be there. So don't question me. Go and question my mother and my father why I was not there. But when the time came, I showed up. And when the time came, I never sold out. When the time came, I was never a collaborator. I came at an early age and nothing will remove me. Attempts were there to silence me with the story of being disrespectful. I'm not disrespectful. I engage robustly. In less than 2 years. Awe musho dinonyana awe.
What do you guys think about Malema's latest move? Is he keeping it real or is he crossing the line? Let us know in the comments below. That's all for today's Tea Buzzers. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe if you enjoyed this video. We'll see you next time with more juicy updates. Until then, stay buzzing.